So this is part 10 of banking project. In this video, let us understand how to make validations such as mobile number validation, email validation, and how the cursor flows, okay, from first text box to second text box, from third, fourth. The cursor should be in proper navigation, and also all the buttons should be enabled, disabled, all should be taken care. Therefore, per project, so you want to make error-free project, so therefore validations also very, very important. So here we'll understand how to write this program to validate the mobile number or email ID, and also we need to more concentrate whether the data is entered to the text box or not. If there is no data, then you have to ask the user to enter the data, then only we'll allow them to save the record. If the boxes are empty and if you try to save the record, then errors will come. So we need to avoid all these things. Therefore here in this video we'll discuss all these factors. And also we are going to use the regex, that is a regular expression. So in regular expression, it will be very useful to compare the email ID. So therefore we will learn like how to use the regular expression in this video. So this is a regular expression pattern for email ID. Concept is simple, but when you combine everything, it looks like a complex. But we have a separate video, we will come out with a separate video. Please keep watch our channel. We will explain you what all this mean and why you have to use this, and how this works. For project download, go to iBlix.com/download, and also please subscribe to our channel. And also if you like the video, click like button, and you want to say something to us, please write in the comment box and send to us. Okay, so we are in Visual Studio, and these are the things which already created step by step. If you not yet watched the videos, like you can watch from the part one, therefore you can learn easily like how you can make the complete project. And also, like if you're looking for the job, you can add up to your resume. So this is the project you have done. So therefore, we have many projects in our list. So download or create yourself and then add up to the resume. Therefore, your resume will be more valuable. That means you have done so many projects, it'll give you a more valuable value. So and easy for you to answer in the examination and get a good job. Anyway, please try this. Okay. Now let's come back and see that first one. We want cursor navigation. So there is one called the tab index here. So when the page opens, where the cursor should be. So first cursor should be at new. So therefore you can make this as a zero, tab index zero. Then when you click new, you should go to account number, come automatically. There is no need to send the cursor over here. Then you have to send the cursor here to select the account type. By default is a zero balance account, and you don't want to select the account type also, then straight away you can send here like. But you want to select the type again and again, so probably you have to use this one. Therefore what you can do is, after this we'll take cursor to this location. Therefore it is a tab index, so this is 0, therefore it's supposed to be 1. From there it should come over here, so therefore it's a 2, then it is, this is 3, then this is 4, then 5, then 6, right? So then here it should come over here, so 7, then it should go here 8, then it should come here 9, then it should come over here 10, then after all this will come over here, therefore it becomes 11. So that's how we can make the cursor movement. So in a form, so you need to check in every form, so where the cursor should come when the form is loaded, from there where it should go. So all you have to do it. So I'll show you like how this works now. So if you go to account details, now you can see that cursor is located over here. If I press the tab key, cursor will go to account type. So you can see that cursor navigating in a order. So previously is not like this, cursor jumps randomly, that we can avoid. This is the one type of validation. So next one, so you see that we already disabled these two buttons. Same, you can disable the save button also. In the beginning there is no job for the save, unless otherwise you enter the data, and you need to click the new button. Therefore you can make disabled. When you click new, now you need to enable this. Therefore you can say save dot, sorry, this is not save. So what is the button number, that you need to check it out, button 1. So therefore you write button 1 dot enabled is equal to true. So once you save the record, you can disable the button. So therefore you can say record saved successfully, then you can disable it. Enabled is equal to false. So therefore if you click again also, the record will not be inserted again. That is a thing. So you need to take care every button should be enabled, disabled accordingly. The next joke is, without having the account number, if you click save, you should not save that one. Right. Now it'll do the job because we are not checking anything. So text box 1.txt. So even there is nothing, you'll try to save. Even you put existing number also, will save. So therefore, we need to check whether we have a data or not. So in order to do this, you have to write one condition here. If text box, you already seen like in other places. So this you need, this is required here also. Then you say exit sub. So don't need to execute this. And also, if there is no account holder name, so you could have tell them please enter the account holder name. So therefore you can say a text box 2 dot exit sub. So here it won't give you any message and all, so straight away it'll come out of the program. But if you want to tell the user, okay, so for example here you can see that message box. Okay, let me copy the message box. Now what will happen? So if it's empty, it will tell you like please enter the account number. So now it will give the message, then it will stop the program. So that's how you can write. So if you want to show the message, you have to use this. If you don't want, you can use this one. So this is to check the whether data is present or not. So next one, max width. Okay, so if you take a mobile number here, so you can see that length is 10. If you enter more than 10 here, so now we'll accept, but in when you save the record, error will come. So now to avoid this, so here also there is a max length property, you need to set to 10 here. So now you can't enter more than 10. So this one is 50, therefore you can say max length is equal to 50. So even for name also, you can see that account name 50, therefore you have to make max length is equal to 50. So everywhere you need to do that one. So for all the controls, you have to set the max length. That is also one property. Next one, here when you enter, you should enter only numbers. You are not supposed to enter the characters. For mobile number, you should enter only numbers. For this, you have to go to events. There is a key press event here. So you have to select the key press event. In a key press event, so there is called the E dot key care. So which key you press, that is there in the E dot key care. Now what we have to do is, we can convert this into ASCII value and then we need to work. So what I'll do is, so dim, let's say a var as integer. Okay, integer 16 is okay, fine. So a var is equal to, so val of, so it's not val, ASC of E dot key care. So ASC of E dot key care is to convert into ASCII value. Let's check it whether it's converted or not. Message box dot show, let's say a var. Okay, so now we can run this. Now here you type 1. So 1 is 49, ASCII value is 49, then 2 is 50, 3, so that is 51, 9, 57, 0, 48. So 48 to 51, sorry 57, 48 to 57 is acceptable range. Therefore, we can check if a var is less than 48. And a var is greater than 57, then you can give the message box dot show please enter number only. Please enter number only. Okay, so after giving the message box, what you have to do is you have to say e dot key char is equal to null. It's null or db null. So this is nothing. Okay, so there is got the nothing. You have to use nothing. Nothing means don't send anything. So for it shouldn't print that particular number or character. Now we'll see that what will happen. So we'll remark this, we don't want. Now type A here. A is accepted. Okay, now we see the message box. A 97. Okay, so you have to use R actually. Both cannot be valid here. So therefore you have to use the R. R less than this, R greater than 57. So now you type A here, 97. Then you can see please enter the number only. So A is not printed now. So now we can remove this message box, is not required. So now if I run this account details, now you can enter 90123456 7 A. A is not accepted. B not accepted. So any character you type, it won't accept. It is accept only numbers. After that also if you type, it not take. So because it will accept only 10 characters, after that it won't take this one. So this is how the logic to validate the mobile number. So we can avoid entering the wrong things. But now what happen? If you press the backspace, so here you can go to account details. A, okay, so 90048, but not 0. So I want to remove that 0. I want to remove that 0. So therefore backspace is 8. Okay, so even for that also it's not accepting. So what you have to do is you have to write if a var is equal to 8, then exit sub. So we don't want to execute the rest of the code. That's how the logic works. Now you can press the backspace. So backspace is working. Right, now we can do the email ID. For email ID, that you need to do it when you click the save button. So here text box 1, text box 2 is over. Now for email ID is a text box 5. For that you required regular expression, therefore you need to import system dot this is okay, regular expressions. Okay, so this is system dot text dot regular expressions. So you need to use the regular expressions. So once you have regular expressions, so first you require a go to save button. So here you need to write the regular expression. Okay, so here you can say dim pattern as string. So 0 to 9, A to Z, capital A to Z. Any character you can enter. So with that, you can use dot also. Then you can use any number of characters. Then compulsory at the rate. Then you can use any number of characters. Right, so you can use characters again. And then dot is again compulsory. After that, you can have A to Z, 2 to 9 characters. So this is the logic here. So with this logic, we'll compare the text box 5, what are the email ID you enter with this pattern. So then if it is true, we don't do anything. Else if it's not correct, we write, so please enter correct email ID. Okay, this is the message will come, and then you can say exit sub. So exit sub to stop the program. So now you can run this. So this is the account details. So click new, then type something, click save, nothing is happening. Okay, here is because text box 2 is equal to empty, therefore it's not showing any message. Okay, sometimes this will happen, then it is very confusing. Therefore what you can do is we can take this up. So please enter the name. Now click new. So you type something, save. So please enter the name. So here you need to enter the name. Then here is there. So now please enter correct email ID. That message will come. So now you need to enter the correct email ID. arun@gmail.com. So now you can select the account type. R0 balance account. You can write Arun. So now you need to enter the mobile number 10234234 and address. So save this, record saved successfully. Now you can see that all these buttons are disabled and this is only enabled. Click new, new number will come, then the save button will be enabled. But you click find, so if there is a record, this is also will be enabled. To find, now these two all are enabled. So now you can able to modify or delete. But this has to be disabled again. So because if this is enabled, if you click save, then again error because 1002 already there. We need to disable that. Therefore, when you say find, you have to disable the button 1. So button 1 enabled is equal to false. So this is how you need to write the coding. This is what very important. So please try all these things, and meanwhile, as we suggested, subscribe to our channel and browse the rest of the videos. Thank you.